Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we are going to cover equity investments with insignificant influence. When a company invests in another company, but owns less than 20% of its voting stock, we usually say the investing company has insignificant influence over the company it invests in. That is because with less than 20% ownership, we usually don't have control over another company's strategic decisions. Let me show you how to account for this type of investment. So, assume on October 2nd, we purchase $5,000 of Nike stock. After this purchase, we own less than 20% of Nike's voting stock and have insignificant influence over Nike. So, to account for this purchase, we debit stock investments for $5,000 and credit cash for $5,000. Now, fast forward to November 15th, and we receive $15 of dividends from Nike. To record these dividends, we debit cash for $15 and credit dividend revenue for $15. Now, let's fast forward to our year end, December 31st, and our portfolio of stock investments, which only includes Nike stock with a cost of $5,000, now has a fair value of $6,000, meaning our portfolio has an unrealized gain of $1,000. And because we have an unrealized gain, we need to make a fair value adjustment to our stock investments portfolio as the unrealized gains or losses get reported on the income statement. To do this, we record a debit to fair value adjustment stock for $1,000. And a credit to unrealized gain income for $1,000. The fair value adjustment stock account is reported on the balance sheet and can either increase or decrease the reported value of the stock investments. In our example, the $1,000 increases the value of the portfolio of stock investments from its $5,000 cost to its fair value of $6,000. We can alternatively report stock investments at the $6,000 fair value, noting the cost is $5,000. We report stock investments as either a current or long-term asset based on how long management plans to hold the stock and how easily it is to eventually sell the stock. On the credit side, the unrealized gain of $1,000 is reported in the other revenues and gains section on the income statement. Now, let's fast forward a bit further to say January 10th of next year, and say we decide to sell some of the stock investment. The shares sold were originally purchased for $600 and are now sold for $700. This results in a realized gain of $100. It is realized because those securities are now actually sold. We record this entry with a debit to cash for $700, a credit to stock investments for $600, and a credit to gain on sale of stock investments for $100. The credit to stock investments removes the cost of these shares from the balance sheet. The gain on sale of stock investments is reported in the other revenues and gains section of the income statement. Also, notice that the fair value adjustment we previously made to the stock investments portfolio does not affect the calculation of a gain or loss from the sale of individual stocks. This is because the fair value adjustment pertains to the entire portfolio of stock investments and not to individual stocks, and is calculated at the end of the accounting period. To wrap it up, remember that the accounting we just covered is used for equity or stock investments with insignificant influence, which is usually the case when a company owns less than 20% of another company's voting stock.